Coming in at 6 inches or 15 centimeters, this is the Hasbro Fortnite versus or X G.I. Joe Snake Eyes 0 Point Edition. Look, in a very short nutshell, I'm a bit of a Snake Eyes sleazebag. As soon as I saw Snake Eyes, I was all over it and wanted it, pre-ordered it. And then I must admit, I kind of forgot about this thing, and eventually it arrived. A pretty huge package that it arrives in. Massively done in this big, huge box, which didn't really need to occur. The figure we'll get through in just a second. Just give you a quick visual at it. And all of the parts and pieces there. We've got a belt with disco grenades. We've got a sheath for his sword and a couple of grenades there as well. Ninja throwing stars, a gas canister. I really don't play Fortnite, so I really don't know. And various kind of kiddie style, but not really, Fortnite weapons, and of course this crazy grenade plunger thing that you have. Not much else really on the packaging. Again, it's such a ridiculously sized box, and we get a kind of cartoon Fortnite rendition on the front, and that is it. A little hologram sticker there saying Fortnite, Epic Games and Hasbro. I suspect there was a lot of licensing money back and forth, Fortnite and Snake Eyes, to do this. Ultimately, though, this figure is a complete repaint of the Snake Eyes that you got with the Timber Pack. The kind of relatively recent 2-pack. I picked mine up at Dorkside a while back, Dorkside Toys. But it's the same figure. So, again, the weapons that come with this are these kind of disco grenades. Now, look, if you play Fortnite, that's great. I'm sure if you're into that, you may love this pack. Ultimately, for me, as a G.I. Joe fan and a Snake Eyes fan, it's okay. Doesn't really do much for me, but it may be doing something for you. And then the grenade, as we talked about, they don't really fit this Snake Eyes, but yeah, they kind of can. We get one of these crazy guns, which could be used with a little paint to kind of work into the G.I. Joe universe. So it's not terrible. No moving parts or anything. No kind of muzzle flashes, that kind of stuff. It's pretty solid though. And one other hand to throw ninja stars, which again, if we look on this hand, is exactly the same. So same hand. And finally, the plunger. I don't even know what these things do. I guess it's a kind of grenade plunger thing. Big part of Fortnite by the looks of it, because loads of figures come with it. And that is it. So, oh sorry, the other weapon was this harpoon gun. So again, not a great deal. And I never showed you the other weapon either, silly me. That weapon, and this one, which actually I think is the more useful of the bunch, which kind of goes with Snake Eyes. However, we do get a sword, same sword as the previous releases, the previous release so far. Same handle, Rashikaji symbol. It's, you know, basically done. We'll show you the other figure to compare in just a second. Wrapped around his chest is this disco belt, as we mentioned. It is, again, exactly the same as the one that is there, just done in black. So, it's just a repaint overall. What I was going to show you was, yes, knife. I thought this was removable. No, it's not removable. This is something weird. So, I mean, they're giving you a bunch of weapons. Clearly, you can harpoon someone to death. You can Tommy gun, machine gun, grenade gun them to death. You can blow them up. You know, we've got a bunch of weapons here. So, maiming and killing someone is clearly the mood of the day. But for some reason, Hasbro then glued these down. Maybe this was an Epic license thing, but they glued the knife here and it will not come out as a separate piece. And they also glued the pistol in this as so it's not a separate piece, which is wildly confusing and just irritating, really. Why would you do that? It's got to be some weird license thing, or, you know, 1,000 moms or whatever they're called kind of going nuts about something. But again, it doesn't make sense. The whole point of Fortnite is beating the crap out of people. On the previous release, you would have been able to remove the weapon there, but yeah, they've glued the thing to hell in there. And the previous release again had a knife. I mean, really, a knife out of all of these weapons that I've showed you earlier on is probably the least offensive of any of them compared to, you know, harpooning someone, blowing the grenade, whatever it may be. But they haven't reduced this, you know, they haven't glued the sword. So it just honestly doesn't make sense. Very bizarre situation to get into. It's like, knife, no, never. Sword, to gut somebody. Yes, that's okay. I'd love to be a fly in the wall of these meetings, and there's probably someone who's in these meetings who you're just like, man, that person's a dick. So, anyway, this is what we get. It is just all slightly different. Repainting, retooling, or not really retooling, just repainting of the previous figure, where we had some kind of browner elements. They're all solid black. Where we had black on this one, it's a kind of grey. The helmet's pretty much the same. There's really no difference in it. Again, that's slightly more brownish tone on the one on the right here, and the darker tone here. Same on the sword. You can see the slight difference there in paint. Otherwise, it is the same. Pants are the same. They're just kind of brownie coloured on one, and they're kind of darker grey on the other. You'll see the boots on the Fortnite one are kind of odd, weird green, a kind of greenish black, with black at the shin and the plate in the front, whereas these ones are solid black with a kind of brown trim around the top. So, you know, again, bits and pieces. Again, Rashikaji Bell. It's the same figure. I've already reviewed this one, so I'm not going to go through much more on this one. So ultimately, I'm saying that the Hasbro G.I. Joe Fortnite was actually a real disappointment. A damn expensive one, I have to add. I could have bought multiples of this at BBTS or Darkside for, or Amazon or somewhere for, really way, way cheaper than I paid for this Hasbro Pulse item, which barely ships to any countries outside the US. So, yeah, honestly, a lot of hype, and stupid me, I get sucked in by, oh my god, Snake Eyes, I have to have it, and there you go. Look, it's not a bad figure, there's plenty of articulation on it, as I went through in the review for this and the Timber. Every bit of articulation is there. You can get pretty epic poses with this guy. There is no real issue on the articulation side whatsoever. Decent, very useful crunches, swivel waists. Leg pins, you can even peel the legs down and up, so there's a whole lot of movement range. Thighs, double joints at the knees, boot cuts, rocking ankles. There's nothing wrong with the articulation. Double joints at the elbows, swivel on the wrists back and forth. Plenty of articulation. The articulation is not the problem here. It's the fact that Hasbro repacked a bunch of frankly rubbish for Snake Eyes fans and Fortnite fans and kind of milked us a little bit. And like Muppets, we bought it. So you know, I'm just as bad here for buying this thing. So, yeah. But you know, it's another Snake Eyes. Pose with one, do something different. I'll definitely be painting the grenades. But you know, you live and learn. But or maybe I don't. Maybe I just never learn. Let us know what you think of the Fortnite Snake Eyes. Yes, I was a Muppet. Don't rip me to shreds in the comments. But let me know if you've bought it. Maybe you love it. And there's nothing wrong with loving this figure. It's a solid figure. It is a good figure. But just the way that Hasbro do this kind of reminds me of Star Wars: The Black Series when they kind of milk out Christmas releases, etc. And it's not great. So, there you go. Let us know. We'll see for more G.I. Joe reviews coming up.